I'm here in Indio, California. Introduce us. Who's here today?
Okay, my name is Amit Katz, nutritionist for Quintana Boxing and Team Perro. This is our man,
Terrence Perro.
Is Perro real name or fake name?
It's my real name, Terrence Perro. Yeah.
Okay.
This is the main man, our coach,
our manager,
Mike Quintana.
This is therefore it's Quintana Boxing.
Yeah. Yes.
This is Ruben. He's our cut man, and Bobby, our coach extraordinaire.
So, Avery, what can you tell us about your fighter here, Perro?
Well, you know, he's a strong fighter. He's getting, you know, he's getting back into it. He's coming off of a two-year layover, but he looked good. There's a couple things we're gonna go back and work on, but we're coming back with vengeance.
Coach, I've seen you work the corner of a lot of different fighters. What can you tell us about this young gentleman?
Well, this young gentleman has a lot of a future ahead of him. He's just inexperienced. A little more work with him, but overall, he comes from what, like they say, good material. It's good. He's a diamond in the rough. You know, you need to cut him, polish him, and make him shine, basically.
What do you say about that?
Hey, we have a good team. From Terrence to Ruben, which is my advisor, to my coach, Bobby, and to admit my
nutritionist.
I'm sorry.
Amit.
Yeah. I would like to say Amit, but Amit.
Yeah, you got to be from Israel. Amit.
You can call me Shirley. After 45 years of people ruining my name, I don't care.
But we have a good team. We have a very good team, and we'll be back. We'll be back.
Let's talk to the man himself. Tonight was a tough one. You got in there. You came in undefeated. First time you didn't win. How does it feel?
It's sad, you know what I'm saying? But I learned a lot, you know what I'm saying? And like my coach said, you know what I'm saying? I had a 2-year layoff, you know what I'm saying? But there's no excuse, but we're going to go back to the drawing board, get it back going, and come back to California, win, and give everybody a lovely show. And yeah, we will make it to the top. Hard work and dedication all the way.
What's your background?
My background.
Do you play any other sports before boxing, or you've just been boxing?
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I've been boxing, you know what I'm saying, for 7 years, you know what I'm saying? I was an amateur boxer, you know what I'm saying, in Denver, Colorado, you know what I'm saying, to 27 wins and 3 losses. You know what I'm saying? My first pro fight was in November, you know what I'm saying, of 2010, you know what I'm saying, against a guy from Nebraska, you know what I'm saying? That fight went pretty good, you know what I'm saying, by the way. It was second round knockout, and then I had like a little 2-year layoff, you know what I'm saying? For some reason, I don't know why, but we back now. I got an awesome team. Awesome coach, awesome cut man, awesome manager, awesome nutritionist. So we have a good team, so we're ready to roll.
You almost came back tonight. Tough first round, but the second round you had it.
Yeah. It was real tough, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, you know what I'm saying, I couldn't get off on no punches. I was, you know what I'm saying, some ring rust, but like I said, there's no excuse. You know what I'm saying, I fought a good guy, a strong guy. You know what I'm saying, I wish I could get a rematch against him one day, but you know what I'm saying, from the time being, go back to the drawing board. And come up with some more, routines, training routines, pick up my weight a little bit, and then get back at it, hit it hard. 230%, 50%, don't matter.
Okay, everyone here, give me your top 3 pound for pound fighters in the world today.
Top 3 pound for pound fighters. Okay, Canelo Alvarez.
Canelo number one?
Yeah, Canelo. He's the future of Golden Boy, by the way.
He's the future of boxing.
Yeah, he's the future of boxing. And Deontay Wilder. And
Nonito Donaire.
Yes.
It's a very interesting pound for pound list, but they're all stars.
Yeah.
What do you say, Amit?
I'd probably go at this point Martinez. Sergio Martinez. Definitely Canelo. Again, you know, these things change from big show to big show. So at the moment, Martinez for sure. Canelo for sure. And just, personal favorite, I got to go Pacquiao.
And I'm going to say Quintana.
Man, nobody's mentioning Mayweather. Tough crowd.
Well, Mayweather was his first, Pacquiao, and Martinez.
Mayweather, Martinez, and Nonito Donaire.
I'm going to say Canelo, Pacquiao, and Martinez.
Why do you guys believe so much in Canelo? I mean, obviously, I believe in it. I'm telling people in a couple of years he'll be pound for pound, but you guys already have him there.
He's tough. I haven't seen nobody like him.
He's hit hard.
In a long time.
He's polished at a very young age.
He's patient. He'll walk a fighter down in a minute. You know, he could, I mean, he hit like a rhino.
And he's better than Chavez, let me tell you.
Better than Chavez Jr.?
He's the king of Mexico. Chavez is done.
Why is he done?
He's he can't make weight. He has a
I'm going to tell you why he's done. I'm going to show you something right now.
Smoking marijuana.
I'm going to show you why he's done.
He's done. And his dad is too much involved. His dad needs to sit down, shut up, and let the coaches coach him. Period. He needs to shut up. That's bottom line. He's got to shut up. Okay? We're going to see. You're going to see it right here.
You're going to see it right here. I'll give you a perfect reason why he's done.
Okay.
Okay, hold on.
All right, coach.
Look at that.
There you go.
There you go.
Pictures tell it.
Okay, I'm going to say that's not real because that kid in the picture is way too skinny to be Chavez Jr. Now, if it was a big dude, maybe. So there you have it. Stay tuned for more. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Segback reporting. Looks like me in that face. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Segback.